it's David from Posh 42, Musician Rantan, Nothing Gained. Today we're checking out the band Cromok and I Don't Belong Here. Now we have done Cromok a couple of times, so I think we've done two videos of theirs already. This was a request by a few people actually have requested this one. Haven't had a chance to do it until now, so let's get on with this. We're going to just do the one at the top here. Oh, excuse me. I haven't had a chance to see if this music video is any good, but it looks like it's a fan cam. So yeah, we'll just do this one at the top. If you like the video, please subscribe, click the bell icon, like and share, leave your comments down below. Please also check out, keep an eye out for new videos, channel coming up from myself. It will be Dave Does, and that will be just a whole series of different things, including there will be some reactions in there, but it'll be a whole load of other stuff as well, which will be stuff that you request me to check out. We're going to be doing the history of some things. We're going to be doing some challenge stuff on there. So yeah, a whole range of stuff going. Let's do Cromok, I Don't Belong Here. I do like it when they do lyric videos though. I do talk over the videos at the moment, so just sorry about that if it's not your thing, but I do have to. It's a copyright issue. I'm getting like a video game vibe now. Sorry, put trainers on. Oh yeah, I remember Cromok now. Always give me this classic 80s, late 80s metal vibe. 86, 87. Looks the end. Okay, so I'm looking for some sort of transition now. So what, 2 minutes in? No, yeah, 2.5 minutes in. Solo's got an almost bluesy-esque sort of vibe to it. I thought with me, Cromok was always, I thought it was a band, full band, not just a very obviously an instrumental piece. You hear like a Joe Satriani, Steve Vai, kind of, you know, Yngwie Malmsteen maybe.
Yeah,
Okay, so that was Cromok and I Don't Belong Here. So, when would I listen to something like that? I think if I was in a car driving and I was just, it's more of a background track, something you can get a kind of vibe off of. And the reason I say a background is, I think for me, it's the rhythm part there. It's a very simplistic backing track, which is obviously designed to showcase the lead guitarist, and the lead guitar parts were really nice. There was some nice technicality in there. It was kind of very, as I said, a bluesy-ish tone to it, because it was more feeling based, and that's what I really liked about that part. I just would have liked to have seen maybe a bit more variation. The only real massive variation came near the end, where they started just doing a bit of a change in the kind of vibe and tempo. Apart from that, the tempo, although they half it occasionally, it was just the same part. There was no kind of significant change, which in a 6 minute song you really do need it. Even Buckethead and Joe Satriani, Steve Vai will do variations to give them something else to showcase the lead off of. So I think for me, for a 6 minute instrumental song which is focused primarily about the lead guitar part, to have the same tempo the whole way through pretty much is challenging to keep audio listener attention. The fact that obviously I'm trying to look at the screen at the same time, and I'm not sort of doing another task. So that's why I was saying I think the song would work, or the music would work really well in kind of a more of a background piece, rather than something, unless you're kind of one of these people that really like to break down tracks and listen to all his solo parts and listen to it intently, maybe that would be your kind of thing. But yeah, I didn't mind it from a technical point of view, and the sound quality and the style, etc. I just think for me it wouldn't be something I'd playlist. But let me know what you think about it in the comments below. If you like the video, please subscribe, click the bell icon, like and share, and I'll see you on another video sometime very soon. Take care.